Hey everybody. A few weeks ago, my wife and I celebrated our 29th wedding anniversary. I took her to Branson, Missouri. Missouri is known as the Show Me State, so I figured I'd show you some of the things that we experienced while we were on our trip.
One of the main reasons I wanted to take her to Branson was for us to see the production of the musical Jesus at the Sight and Sound Theater.
If you ever get the chance to see a production at a Sight and Sound Theater, go. They have those throughout the United States, and I've been to a few different productions at the one in Branson, Missouri. It doesn't matter what the show is, it's going to be fantastic. It's really indescribable. At one point in the show that we saw, Roman soldiers rode horses down the aisle through the audience up onto the stage. It's just phenomenal. We really enjoyed it. The hotel we stayed in Branson was the newest resort hotel owned by Bass Pro Shops. It's called the Angler's Lodge. It's actually in Hollister, Missouri. Branson, Springfield, Hollister, all those little Missouri towns are very close together. And the world hub of the Bass Pro Shops is in Springfield, Missouri. And I'll give you a little background on Bass Pro Shops.
I love to bass fish.
And I used to be a big NASCAR fan until Dale Earnhardt died. I guess that makes me a certified redneck. But my net worth is not equal to another certified redneck from Missouri who also loves to bass fish and who also loved Dale Earnhardt. Johnny L. Morris was born in 1948 in Springfield, Missouri. When he was 24 years old, in 1972, he founded Bass Pro Shops when he began selling fishing equipment in the back of one of his father's Brown Derby liquor stores in Springfield, Missouri. Today, Bass Pro Shops retail chain stores with hunting and fishing supplies are found all across America, and their internet sales are worldwide. And according to Forbes magazine, Johnny L. Morris is worth $4.1 billion.
That's a young Johnny Morris right there. Now this hotel knows how to serve breakfast.
One of Bass Pro Shops' attractions in Springfield, actually it's a bunch of them, is called Top of the Rock. There's a golf course, golf pro shop, restaurants, and a really cool golf cart trail. They have an entire fleet of golf carts that you can drive actually through a cave that has waterfalls and see some really awesome scenery. Take a look.
Is the video on?
I'm going to send this to Mudge and ask. He's a geologist. I'm going to ask him what all kinds of rock we're looking at right here.
Hold over to the side and look down. Did you get all that?
Coming right up to the left. That's pretty good. And keep coming up to the left. That's slick. This next little place they named Horseshoe Bridge and Falls.
Now why the name is that? Why on earth would they have named it that?
That's so pretty.
Why the name is that? Sucker?
Oh, that's a good lady.
Every day at sundown, weather permitting, they have what they call their sunset celebration. This little chapel you're going to see, Johnny Morris had that built for his daughter to get married in. Take a look at this. This is the infinity pool. This Table Rock Lake. We'll have a sunset celebration here. Fire that cannon. Have bagpipes playing.
What is that?
I think so. I do believe we just had a wedding in here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can see how big the thing really is. Dying Indian.
I got a CT. I got a first CT.
Oh, yeah. Much
better. Well, as usual, anytime a Higgins goes anywhere, there's an incident. This trip was no exception.
Lifetime. Tonight at Top of the Rock, we're very glad to have you here with us for our sunset celebration. So take it away, Mr. Dan Zacher.
Mike, we're going to have to stop the ceremony. We have a medical emergency.
Oh, okay. I am sorry. Somebody.
Just before that bagpipe player started, someone passed out down on the grass pretty close to the chapel. Turned out everything was okay. It was hot as blue blazes that weekend. And I think the person just got dehydrated, got too hot, and passed out. They asked any medical personnel there, anyone who knew CPR, to please go to that grass area by the cannon. So I took off, and by the time I got to this little gate that led to the walkway, a lady was coming back with a blue dress on and carrying her high heels. She had run down there. She said, "Never mind, they don't need us. I'm a nurse." She said, "There are already 30 people down there who are either doctors, paramedics, nurses, anesthetists, or something that are taking care of that person." Later that night at the restaurant, while we were having dinner, I heard someone talking about the incident, and it was a man who had been down there, and I couldn't help it. I told my wife, I said, "I've got to go ask him what happened." He was a fire chief from somewhere there in a local town in Missouri, and he said that that person was okay. Paramedics came out with an ambulance and all, but by the time they got there, they had the person stabilized, and they didn't even leave in an ambulance. So all's well that ends well.
Huge buffalo heads in the bar.
Dinner at the Buffalo Bar was fantastic. The chef knew exactly how to cook a perfect medium steak. I had no idea that the entire ground floor of that Top of the Rock facility is a Native American museum, which holds possibly the largest amount of Native American Indian artifacts of any museum in the United States of America. My wife and I spent 3 hours in that place the next day, and what you're about to see is just a snowflake at the tip of Mount Everest. This next entire room was full of ceremonial pipes.
Just like that one.
Man, this is the dead gum pipe room right here. All this whole case down through there is all pipes.
I'm gonna leave this one.
Look at that one. And that one. They're twisted.
Wow.
Isn't that cool?
Man, that's some wild pipe carving right there. Leave. Oh, that's a neat one.
Hair was considered an extension of the person's soul. For a warrior to acquire hair from another warrior added power and strength to his own shirt and feet.
Another war shirt with scalps.
A hair extender.
Man. Wouldn't want to tie in with the warrior who wore this one. Geronimo. There's Geronimo right there.
So crazy.
A cradle board, yeah, it's like a mobile. They could play with things, little stuff would hang down there the baby could play with.
Isn't that neat?
Well, this kind of thing's been around. The mobile for them to mess with's been around a lot longer than we thought, huh?
1850.
I am blown away. My mind is just blown here. I had no idea they had this much stuff in this place. We're only halfway through this.
They actually have a desk that was used by Abraham Lincoln in a law office in Illinois before he ran for public office. And they have the table that George Armstrong Custer sat at to finalize the plans for the Battle of the Little Bighorn.
Custer's desk. This used to be their driving range. They said they left one afternoon, came back the next morning. There was a 90-foot wide,
70 or something.
Like a 90-foot wide and I don't know, 100-something-foot deep hole here. Just where the driving range is, just sank. It's a sinkhole. So they're developing it and going to put trails in there. They're excavating it out. It's going to take about another year and a half to finish it and have golf cart trails through there. Actually, they're going to ride side-by-side ATVs through there is what he said, to go exploring in those caves and all. They're like 7 different caves that I think are all interconnected down there. Wild.